Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is Shreya Jadhav and today we are going to learn English Class 10 Chapter 2 Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom written by Nelson Mandela. So let us know something about the author. Nelson R. Mandela, born 18th July 1918, died 5 December 2013, was a South African revolutionary, political leader and a philanthropist who served as president of South Africa from 1994 to 1999. He was country's first black head of state and first elected in a usually representative democratic election. Nelson Mandela has become South Africa's first black president after more than three of white rule. Mr. Mandela's African National Congress, ANC, party won 252 of 400 seats in the first democratic elections of South Africa's history. The inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Building Amphitheater in Pretoria today, attended by politicians and dignitaries from more than 150 countries around the world. Never again will this beautiful land experience the oppression of one by another, said Nelson Mandela in his address. Jubilant scenes on the street of Pretoria, followed by ceremony with blacks, whites and coloured celebrating together, more than 1 lakh South African men, women and children of all races sang and danced with joy. Genre: this speech is delivered by Nelson Mandela while becoming South Africa's first president. Explanation of the chapter. In the previous video, we have gone through the story in brief, and in this, we are going to go through paragraph. 10th May dawned bright and clear. For the past few days, I had been pleasantly decided by dignitaries and world leader who were coming to pay their respect before the inauguration. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders of South African soil. So over here, the speech is delivered by Nelson Mandela and he is giving us a brief idea or scene that on 10th of May, the ceremony was going to be held. And before that, many leaders from different countries have come for this inauguration ceremony. The ceremonies took place in a lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Building in Pretoria. For decades, this has been the seat of white supremacy, and now it was the site of a rainbow gathering of different colors and nations for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. So this was the very first time that in the amphitheater in Pretoria, first time so many people were gathered for the inauguration. And moreover to that, over here it is given rainbow gathering. It means that there was no biasness on based of color or caste or creed. So this was South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. On that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zinani. On the podium, means on the stage, Mr. D. Clark was first sworn in as second deputy president. Then Thabo Mbeki was sworn in as first deputy president. When it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the Constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the Republic and its people. To the assembled guests and the watching world, I said. So over here, when the ceremony began, the first person was Mr. D. Clark, who was sworn as the second deputy president. Then Thabo Mbeki was the first deputy president, and then it was turn of Nelson Mandela to sworn the ceremony. And now what we are going to learn is what he has said in his speech and what he felt. Today, all of us do by our presence here. Confer glory and hope to newborn liberty. Out of experience of extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long, must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. So we all know that Africa was for a very longer time duration under the slavery of Britishers. So after a very long time duration, they were free. They were democratic now. So now it was that South African people have got a new life and they have got a newborn liberty. And the human disaster which was been done by the Britishers now have come to an end. And they will build up a new society on which the whole human race would be really very proud. We, who were outlaws not as long ago, have today been given the rare privilege to be host to the nations of the world on our own soil. In olden times, the African people, because they were having dark black skin, because of that thing, they were not considered as human beings. They were not given that privileges and chance to study. They were considered as slaves in America and many other countries. But over here, Nelson Mandela is telling that today is something different, because today so many countries' leaders have come over here, have come to their own land, South Africans' land. They have come and they have got the privilege, means the South African people have got the privilege that they are the host and the other nations' leaders are their guest. So this is a very big thing for them, that now the South African people are also considered as human beings and they also will be given those rights. We thank all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take possession with people of our country of what is, after all, a common victory for justice, for peace, for human dignity. So over here, Nelson Mandela is thanking all the international guests or leader who have come for this inauguration ceremony. We have at last achieved our political emancipation. We pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender and other discrimination. Now Nelson Mandela is now promising not only to their own country people, but he is promising to all the leaders who are present over there that now as their country is liberated, or now as they are free or a democratic nation, they will eradicate all the discrimination happening within their boundaries. Never, never and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the oppression of the one by another. That now nobody in South Africa will be telling that this person is not able to or is would not be considered as a human being, because now that thing has stopped, because now the nation is free. Everyone have right to stand on what they think. The sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Let freedom reign. God bless Africa. A few moments later, we all lifted our eyes in an awe as a spectacular array of South African jets, helicopters and troops carriers rode in perfect formation over the Union buildings. It was not only a display of pinpoint precision and military force, by a demonstration of military's loyalty to democracy, to a new government that had been freely and fairly elected. Only moment before, the highest general of South African Defence Force and police, their chest backed with ribbons and medals from days gone by, saluted me and pledged their loyalty. I was not unmindful of the fact that not so many years before, they would not have saluted but arrested me. Finally, the chevron of Impala jet left a smoke trails of black, red, green, blue and gold of new South African flag. So over here, after the speech was over by Nelson Mandela, this scene happened that the jet planes were in the air and they saluted, and the formation was really very good, and the highest official of the military force also saluted Nelson Mandela because now he was the president of South Africa. And he is remembering that it might be a possibility that years back he might have arrested Nelson Mandela. But today, as he is the president, he is saluting him. And after that, in a V pattern, the jet planes left a smoke trail of black, red, green, blue, and gold. Those were the colors of South African flags. The day was symbolized for me by playing of our two national anthems and the vision of white singing Nekoshi Sikle I Africa and black singing Die Stem, the old anthem of the Republic. Although they once despised, they would soon know the words by heart. So as both the national anthems were new for them, after a certain time duration, the people would learn it by heart. On the day of inauguration, I was overwhelmed with the sense of history. In the first decade of 20th century, a few years after a bitter Anglo-Boer war and before my own birth, the white-skinned people of South Africa patched up their differences and erected a system of racial domination against dark-skinned people of their own land. The structure they created formed the basis of one of the harshest, most inhuman societies the world had ever known. Now, in the last decade of 20th century and my own 8th decade as a man, that system had been overturned forever and replaced by one that recognized the rights and freedoms of all people regardless of color of their skin. So now over here in South Africa, basically there were Britishers living, there were black African people living, and there were colored people. Now who are these colored people? One of the parent could be either white and one of the parent was black. So whatever children they used to have, they were known as colored people. So now all this discrimination in South Africa was increasing, and Nelson Mandela have observed. He was grown in this sort of society and atmosphere. But today in this inauguration ceremony, he is telling that now this discrimination have come to an end. That day had come about through the unimaginable sacrifices of thousands of people, people whose suffering and courage can never be counted or repaid. He is thanking all those people who have given their lives for the freedom of South Africa. I felt that day, as I have on so many other days, that I was simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before me. That long and noble line ended and now began again with me. I was pained that I was not able to thank them and that they were not be able to see what their sacrifices had wrought. Now he is saying that I salute all the patriots who have given and sacrificed their life for the nation, and if they were alive today, they would be really very happy, and Nelson Mandela would personally thank them for the same. The policy of apartheid created a deep and lasting wound in my country and my people. All of us will spend many years, if not generations, recovering from that profound hurt. So now it was not easy for South African people to come out from that trauma of discrimination. It would take a long time duration, or it may take even years. But the decades of oppression and brutality had another unintended effect, and that was that it produced the Oliver Tambos, the Walter Sisulus, the Chief Lethulis, the Yusuf Dados, the Bram Fischer, the Robert Subukwis of our time. These are the great personalities whom Nelson Mandela used to follow. men of such extraordinary courage, wisdom and generosity that their like may even ever be known again. Perhaps it requires such depth of operation to create such heights of character. My country is rich in minerals and gems that lie beneath its soil, but I have always known that its greatest wealth is its people, finer and truer than the purest diamonds. So over here, Nelson Mandela is telling that the people, the South African people, have extraordinary courage, wisdom and generosity. Moreover to that, South Africa land is considered that over here, over there you can find plenty of gems and diamonds. But over here he is comparing those gems and diamonds with their people because they are much more precious to him. It is from these comrades in the struggle that I learned the magic of meaning of courage. Time and again, I have seen men and women risk and give their lives for an idea. I have seen men stand up to attack and torture without breaking, showing the strength of resilience that defies the imagination. I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. The brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers that fear. Over here, Nelson Mandela is telling that his comrade, means the friends, have struggled a lot in getting this freedom. And time and again, he always remembers and is always thankful to them that not only men, women, but also children have supported and have sacrificed their lives for the freedom and the democracy. And he will be always obliged to them for the same. And he says that brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers that fear. That each and every person have some sort of fears within themselves, but the person who overcome those fear, that is considered as one of the best or a brave man. No one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin or his background or his religion. People must learn to hate. And if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. For love comes naturally to human heart, then its opposite. Even in the grimmest time in prison, when my comrades and I were punished to our limits, I could see a glimmer of humanity in one of our guards, perhaps just for a second, but it was enough to reassure me and keep me going. Men's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. Over here, he is telling that we cannot separate men on basis of their color or skin or through which background they are coming or what religion they are following. But what is more important, if people can hate each other, it is likewise that those people could be taught to love each other, because love is that feeling which comes naturally to human beings. And he is talking about the time when Nelson Mandela and his friends were in prison. They used to see that even the guards, who were maybe colored people or maybe white people, they also have that humanity. They would not show it every now and then, but for a fraction of a second they would show that their still humanity exists. And because of this thing, Nelson Mandela got a boost that whatever he is doing could be beneficial for the nation. In life, every man has two obligations. Obligations to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children. And he has an obligation to his people, his community, his country, in civil and human society. Each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclination and abilities. But in a country like South Africa, it is almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of those obligations. So over here, Nelson Mandela is telling that as a human being living in the society, he is supposed to support not only his family or his wife or his children or parents, but he is also supposed to support the nation. But having that black or dark color skin, he was unable to do so. But now that thing has also changed. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. In South Africa, a man tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart. A twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. So now he is talking about that if you are born in South Africa, it was very difficult for the South African people to satisfy all the needs of being a good husband, man, brother, father, and to be an ideal citizen and to work for it. But somehow he have managed both the parts. I was not born with hunger to be free. I was born free. Free in every way that I could know. Free to run in the fields near my mother's hut. Free to swim in clear streams that ran through my village, free from the roast millies under the stars, and ride the broad back of slow-moving bulls. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. So over here, men always have some restrictions, or we can say rules and regulations, that we are supposed to compulsory follow. We don't have any sort of options or choice. We do not get. If we follow those rules, it is really very good for us. But if we think out of the box, it becomes difficult for us. So over here, Nelson Mandela has also done the same thing, that he thought not of his people or of his tribe or of his community. He thought about the whole Africa. So he had to pay price for that also. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, when I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that I began to hunger for it. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom, only myself. The transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased and go where I choose. Later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I yearned for the basic and honorable freedom for achieving my potential. So now Nelson Mandela is talking that how he changed from his boyhood into the real world when he came. That when we are young, we have our basic needs, that whatever we want, we could accomplish those sort of things. Like if we want to go anywhere, no one should stop us, either our parents or the teachers. But after a certain time duration, he faced the actual reality of life, that freedom is something else apart from this, of earning my keep, of marrying and having family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brothers, sisters were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That is when I joined African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life, that transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, that drove a law-abiding atronymy, to become a criminal that turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home, that forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. So over here, when he actually came to know that he was not only person who was suffering, when he actually came to know what was the actual meaning of freedom, he saw that he was not the one who was curtailed, means he was restricted from his freedom. Then he saw that each and every people in the South Africa were curtailed, were not permitted to do according to their wish and choice. So now he was not only thinking about his own freedom, but he was also thinking about the freedom of the nation. And at that time duration, not only he was a husband, but now his whole viewpoint of living a life changed. Now he has become a person who was an authorized person. He also became a criminal, and he changed from a loving husband to a man without home. Even so, he was a very loving person, but now he was supposed to live a life as a criminal or as a monk. I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedom I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. Freedom is indivisible. The chains of any one of my people were the chains on all of them. The chains on all my people were the chains on me. Now he is thinking that self-sacrificing is one of the best thing. No, many people, or we can say most of the people, have this sort of tendency. If we do not get something, we let it go very easily. We do not know, attempt till the end. And this thing Nelson Mandela didn't like. He fought. He fought for the freedom, not only his personal freedom, but the freedom and the democracy of the whole nation. And he's saying that the chains of anyone of my people were the chains on all of them. And the chains for all the people were chains for him. I knew that the oppressed must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. He is locked behind the bar or prejudice, a narrow-mindedness. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom, just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken away from me. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. So over here, the person who is prisoner, he is also not taken away from his freedom, and the person who is punishing, he is also taking away his freedom. So the person who is having this narrow-mindedness of taking someone else's freedom is not the correct thing. Each and every person who is born has right to live the life the way they want to live. And we are not the one who can rob other person's liberty or humanity. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. If you are having any doubts, you can ask in the comment section below.